Hi, let's run Growth Simulator. I will take a real case, analyze it, and question for you what you would do if you own the project. And you will see what product owners did and achieve really good results. I will show you all numbers. So Ultimate Guitar is number one website if you use music instrument. If you're a beginner or pro, you would know it and use it. And the main traffic is Google. So they have five layers. Layer number one is website with 500,000 of users. Layer two is different landings. Layer three is payment methods. Layer four, you enter the payment data. And layer five, you complete the purchase. So let's go deeply. It's a title page, 50,000 visitors. What you would do here? The main goal is to convert people to go to the promo page. So pro version, as you see, it's red one. So this banner take over to the next level. And this banner has 4% of conversion. Also, in specific songs, they have tabs. Tabs also go to specific landing to upgrade the customer. And it has 11% of conversion. And as you see, it's biggest traffic because, of course, the homepage and lots of people coming directly to the song. And it produces much more traffic than ever on title page. And of course, in search, people using search. And when they search for songs, they also have a banner with about 9% conversion to go to promo page. So this first layer, like three ways how to get to the next one. The second one is landing that try you convert. And you can also, two options, you can try it for free or get welcome offer. And let's say it's the same result. So you get offer or you try for free, it's still good for us. Let's convert both. And 50,000 visitors come to here. So what you would do on that page? What you dislike here? Let's think. What you would dislike here? What would you change? Also, the third layer is like, as I said, there are two of them. If person clicks try for free from in previous layer, they get 5,000 visitors with 40% of conversion. By the way, 40% of conversion. It's also nice. And also, if person clicks get welcome offer, they get an offer like this. And there are 2,000 visitors with 50% of conversion. And then all of them switch to fourth layer, payment.data entry. There are 3,000 people coming here. And as you see, 3,000 people comes here, but only 400 of them complete. So the main idea, what you would do, what would you change? Please generate yourself, I don't know, three, five, 10 hypotheses. What is your idea? What you would change? The idea to increase sales. Now they have 400 sales. It could be period, one day, one week, one month, it doesn't matter. But the idea, the goal is increase number of purchases. Just formulate three hypotheses. What you would do? Formulation could be like that. If we change try for free button, let's say, from one color to other, we will get conversion plus 20%. Because green is more, green is better. People trust green more than red. You can move my video back, see every step and think what you would do to increase sales at the endpoint. Okay, what guys did? Firstly, they did personalized landings. For example, when people see song and click to upgrade, the upgrade page will be personalized as the page before. Very logically, and they get really nice results. But let's talk in numbers. So guys, change tutorial a little bit. Earlier tutorial was about the product. So from your mobile app, when you open the product, you see the tutorial. So they replay this tutorial by asking customer questions. By the way, when they just ask question, what kind of instrument you like, you use, what kind of music you like is your favorite, and by the way, then they provide the pricing. The main idea is just they ask customer specific related questions, but these questions just go, the answers go to the recycle bin. So it didn't influence any choice later. So your ideas, how much, maybe it's increase or decrease conversion at that level, your opinion. Just instead of product introduction, they just ask customer questions related with the product and nothing else. They just put answers to recycle bin, just ask questions. So the result was plus 20% to conversion. So people, 20% more people continue. Can you imagine just ever stupid steps with some logic can provide positive results? But okay, Growth Hacker said, let's switch from try pro for free button to start free trial. Let's test it. So guys tested. What is your opinion? They decrease conversion or increase conversion? Your opinion, just they rename the button from try pro for free to start free trial. Which button is better? So by the way, result showed plus 140%. Wow, they increased 2.4 times their sales. Just changing the button name. I don't know what is the logic. Possibly people, beginners, they think, I don't like to be pro. I just would like free trial. I don't need pro. Or maybe try pro, it's pro version. I try pro, I'm not a pro. I just, what is pro? I don't know what is the logic. But they got incredible results just renaming the button. So I just showed you the example. You can use it in your product as well. On the next videos, I will show you more methods and I will talk more about hypotheses.